the leader will ask it, they will all barakallahu fikum give it to them all. طيب. So now, and we all know, barakallahu feekum, that from those who that refuse to give the zakat, right, from at the time of Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu anhu, that Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, he fought them. But prior to that, barakallahu feekum, in the Sunan of Abi Dawud, Sheikh Muhammad, Sheikh Zayd ibn Muhammad al-Madkhali hafizahullah, rahimahullah, in his explanation, he mentioned this. He said that giving it to them, giving the zakat to the ruler, it is something that is wajib if they ask for it. So لا يجوز لأحد. It is not permissible for no one, barakallahu fikum, to ask for the zakat except the ruler. طيب. Because it is also from his rights. He said it is from his rights أن يطالب منه, for him to be asking about the zakat. He say, so therefore, to give it to him, to give it the zakat to the ruler, he say, withholding from this, he say, أَمْرٌ لَا يَجُوزُ لَهُ أَبَدًا. It is not something that will never be permissible. The ruler asks you for the zakat and you withhold, this is not permissible. But look at the hadith of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. لهذا قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في المانعي. في المانع الزكاة, and the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said in regard to the one that refused to pay the zakat. Look at what the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم he say آخذوها وشرط ماله شرط الشيء شرط الشيء نصفه. We mentioned this. We know the word of the شرط الشيء, meaning the شرط of something, it means half of something. You remember when we study أصول, ملخص الفقه, we mentioned this, right? So he mentioned that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said that we will take إنا آخذوها, that we will take that zakat وَشَرْطِ مَالِهِ, and half of his wealth. For the one that refused to take what? To give the ruler the zakat. Yes, and he say, عُقُوبَةً, and it is a punishment for him. Allahu Akbar, Jazakallahu Khairan. And it is a punishment for him. So the one that refused to give the zakat, the ruler has the right to come get the zakat and get half of his wealth. As he mentioned, and this is in the Sunan of Abi Dawood, Kitab al-Zakat, and this is Barakallahu Fikum, and Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah sahaha hadha al-hadith. He has authenticated this hadith. If you go to Sunan Abi Dawood, this hadith number is 1575. And Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah, he authenticated this narration. He said this is by Abu Dawood, Kitab al-Zakat. Maybe I can tell you inshallah next time, but he didn't mention who related. And he mentioned Shaykh Zayd ibn Muhammad al-Madkhali, he mentioned, he say عُقُوبَةً, and this is a punishment. He say يَأْخُذُ الزَّكَاةِ, he will take that zakat. Look, the ruler will take the zakat. وَيَأْخُذُ نِصْفَ مَالِهِ عُقُوبَةً, and he will take half of his wealth as a what? As a punishment. And he say وَالْوَلِي بَعْدَ النَّبِي صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أي وَلِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ إِذَا جَحَدَ إِنسَانَ الزَّكَاةِ ومنعها فإن له أن يعاقبه يأخذها ويأخذ نفس نصف ماله. He said that whoever is the wali, i.e. the ruler, the Muslim ruler after the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, an individual he denied paying the zakat. He denied paying the zakat. He refused paying the zakat, and he prevents, right? He prevents the ruler from taking the zakat. He say that it is for him yu'aqibuhu. He will punish him by way of ya'khudhuha. He will take the zakat. Wa ya'khudh nisfu malihi, and he will take half of his wealth. And he will take half of his wealth. And he say wa hakadha baqiya as-sadaqat al-wajibah التي مصرفها لمصالح المسلمين يولي ذلك الولي المسلمين أو نواهبه المأذون لهم بذلك. And he say likewise, all other types of sadaqah, all other types of sadaqah that can be also given to the wali, meaning to the wali al-amr, to the leader, to the Muslim leader, so he will spend it wherever he see fit to spend it. Wherever he see fit to spend it. مثلا, an individual have, let's say, $1,000 to give in charity. Not zakat, but charity. Right? He got $1,000 to give in charity. He can go ahead and give it to the Muslim ruler. So the Muslim ruler can see wherever it fit for him to tasarrufat, to be barakallahu fikum, to say, okay, I think this $1,000, I'ma pave this road. Or there is a masjid down the block, that is, the roof is collapsed, I'ma, you know, do it like this. Or he will just, a person might have a problem, and he will give it to him. So however he see fit. So this is what barakallahu fikum Sheikh Zayd ibn Muhammad al-Madkhali have mentioned in his explanation. And this is barakallahu fikum the benefit of, alhamdulillah, doing al-muqarana, to take, alhamdulillah, from the explanation of the scholars, and alhamdulillah, so we can have yani a wider view in this. طيب, so therefore here we go ahead now in mentioning about والصلاة الجمعة. This is a new print, inshallah. والصلاة الجمعة. Establishing the Salatul Jum'ah khalfahu, behind the leader, the Muslim ruler. Right? Establishing the Salatul Jum'ah behind the Muslim ruler. And likewise, wa khalfa man wallahu ja'izatun. And likewise, to pray behind the one that has been appointed by the Muslim ruler. It is permissible. It is that which is to be done. Shaykh Rabi, may Allah give him good in his life, in the hereafter, he say, يعني صلاة الجمعة خلف الإمام وخلف من والله من الأمراء والقضاة وأئمة المساجد. And he say, this is the meaning of praying the صلاة الجمعة, praying the صلاة الجمعة behind the Imam. Here the Imam, it means what? The ruler, the Muslim ruler. وَمَنْ وَلَّاهُ, or whoever he has appointed, whoever he has appointed, مِنَ الْأُمَرَى, from بَارَكَ اللَّهُ فِيكُمْ, the other يعني, leaders, وَقُضَاتٌ, and from the judges, and likewise from the imam of the masajid. Whoever the imam, the meaning the Muslim ruler, has appointed as establishing the Salatul Jum'ah, then it is for the person, the Muslim, it is for the person of the Sunnah to pray behind him. It is for him to pray behind him. And he mentioned, يَقُولُ جَائِزَةٌ بَاقِيَةٌ تَامَّةٌ رَكَعَتَيْنِ, that Salatul Jum'ah, it will remain to be two rak'ah, and to be two complete rak'at. Shaykh Rabi, he say, yani, meaning هذه الجمعة, that Salatul Jum'ah has to be two rak'at, It cannot be more. Meaning you cannot go after your house and pray more. Or pray dhuhr or whatever the case might be. He mentioned Imam Ahmad say, وَمَنْ أَعَادَهُمَا فَهُوَ مَبْتَدِعٌ. And whoever repeats it afterward, then he is a mubtadi'. Whoever repeats it afterward is a mubtadi'. Now the Muslim ruler might not be a mubtadi'. He is a tyrant. He is an evil person. He kill people left and right. He take their wealth, right? For instance. But he might not be a mubtadi'. He's a criminal, but he's not a mubtadi'. But the one that did not pray behind him, or he added to those two rakat, he is mubtadi'. Now, which one of these two worst? Without a doubt. وَيَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. And they think that they are guided. Now, you criticizing the ruler to be evil. He drinks a khamr. He drinks alcohol. I'm not going to pray behind him Salatul Jummah. Oh, he's a this, he's a that. I'm not going to pray behind him Salatul Jummah. Now he's talking about the Muslim ruler, the leader. But you go, you pray Jummah because you don't want him to, you know, chop your head. But when you go home, you're going to pray Salatul Dhuhr. That two rak'ah of Dhuhr that you think that this is what is righteous. No, هَذَا خِلَافٌ لِلْأَثَرِ. This is in opposition of the narration. This is in opposition with the narration. We might pray earlier than 7:45. Inshallah. So he mentioned, بَعْدُ النَّاسِ, some of the people. He said, يُعِدُ Salatul Jum'ah. Some of the people, they will repeat the Salatul Jum'ah. They will repeat the Salatul Jum'ah. He said, يعني لعذرٍ في نظره. He will convince himself of a valid excuse. So therefore, he will repeat his Salah. He convinced himself of what? That I have an excuse to repeat my Salah. في نظره, in his own opinion, not based on the text, not based on the nusus, but rather barakallahu fikum, في نظره, in his own opinion, in what he deemed to be right, in what he deems to be right, في نظره, in what he thinks, يعني إما بأنه ما بلغ العدد الأربعين وإما لأن الإمام يرى صلاته ليس صحيحة وهذا شر من ذاك. Right, من ذاك. Right, من ذاك. Right, من ذاك. So the reason why he say من ذاك, it is because he gave you two reasons that the individual think that he has to repeat his salah. The first excuse that he sees is what? That the number did not reach 40. Meaning there was not 40 men in Salatul Jum'ah. So therefore he will see that I will repeat my salah. Because why? There was no 40 men. And you know where the number 40 came from? Because there was a caravan from the Quraysh. And you know, the Arabs, they were merchants, right? So the caravan coming from Sham, from Yemen, and the like, so it came. And now this is what they say. This is what they say. Amma, being sahih or not, this event, but the Ashab al-Madahib, wala siyama, the Malikiyun, if you go to the book Al-Hashmawiyu, this is what he reveals. This is what he mentioned. This is the dalil that he gives for the Arba'un. And Al-Hashmawi is the second book after Al-Akhdari. Right? In